And good day, everybody. I am Connor MacIvor, Connor with Honor here at Realty One Group in Santa Clarita, California. This is my buyer video series where I talk about how I walk through residences with my real estate buyers. Now, we've brought you a lot of video content regarding the first steps, curb appeal, even before that, the research that I do for my buyers on real estate so they don't have to go it alone and I can add that expert type of opinion just because I've been doing this since 1998 and I've dealt and listed and sold and represented thousands of buyers and sellers. So here we are. We're going to talk today about plumbing. And one of the things of being a local agent, that local resource that really gives much benefit to the buyer, is they know things about the residences that you're potentially looking at in different areas built by different builders over the years. The reason why that's important is because if we're going to talk about plumbing today, which we are, some of the houses had plastic piping that was put in. Some of them had repipes done by homeowners association groups, and some of them still have the old pipe that was deemed not worth basically the price of installation back in the day. So there's issues that come along. Whenever I walk into a residence, I know this going in. So if it potentially had some kind of a galvanized steel pipe that was related or shown to be horrible and broke early or caused all sorts of problems in residences, I'll know that. So then I want to move forward and find out if there was a repipe at any point and who had that repipe responsibility. Was it the homeowners association that took care of that, if there happened to be one, or was it the individual homeowner? In some cases, some of the properties, they're holding on to that old piping, just kind of fixing it here and there, just waiting for, well, the ultimate thing to happen, which would be a whole home flood. We don't want that for our buyers. We want to make sure that you're well protected, and at least going in, you know, if they still have the same piping from before and it's something that has been proven to be horrible and have caused lots of flooding in the past, lots of leaks with the other residences in the area, then we're going to want to find out what the cost of that repiping would be. And that would be something as a buyer you would want to do first, or potentially negotiate that with the seller. So when we do write the offer, we write it understanding that the seller's potentially going to help us with that fee to have the home repiped at the close of escrow, or they're at least willing to discount the home, and we'll have to figure that out as we move through it. But piping is important. Some of the portals that you look for, I look under sinks, I look under cabinets, the different cabinets that have the piping inside of them, and bathroom vanities and so on, and also in the garage, specific to the hot water heater, and also if they have one of those tankless water heaters as well. You can usually tell if there's been things that have been changed or done. You'll see copper piping exposed in some cases if there happened to be a repipe, but sometimes galvanized isn't going to show anything, and also that plastic piping isn't going to show, and there's other types as well. So going in and knowing what to look for with regard to yourselves as home buyers and the agent that you select, incredibly important. Plumbing is one of those things that really is area dependent out here in Santa Clarita Valley. Some homes have great plumbing, some homes not so good. We'll talk about more later. I am Connor with Honor. Make sure you save my number. You never know when you may need it. I'll talk to you on the next one. Check out Connor with Honor on Google. Be safe. We'll talk to you later. Take care.